I want to talk about an individual named Dave Grossman, a guy who might be able to make the claim to have trained members of law enforcement and in law enforcement related fields more than virtually anyone else. And what he's been training them in is insane. And it's not difficult to imagine how it could have helped to contribute fairly directly to the widespread police brutality that we see on a daily basis in America. So he has a thing he calls killology. And I can define it, but you almost don't have to. If it's called killology, it's not good. But anyway, he created and popularized it. It instructs his students to be less hesitant to use deadly force in defense of their innocent neighbors. His fixation on this mentality is seemingly fueled with a messianic self-appointment to save the flocks, as he calls, those are civilians, by training sheepdogs, which he defines as lawfully armed community members, to treat even the smallest of American towns like war zones laced with imminent threats. So he's got killology. He says, all of you are too hesitant to murder people, slash I'm really into Christian imagery. Anyway, in his America, it's a terrifying place where police are both the primary targets of and defenders against super predation. Though many independent sources show that the violent crime rate in America has steadily declined since the early 1990s, Grossman maintains that America is now scarier than ever, and that cops may well be the ones with the most to fear. He says, we know that if it were not for all the body armor, bulletproof vests worn by officers, law enforcement fatalities in the United States would easily be double or even triple what they are today. If this is not war, then you tell me what is, and I will not listen to you. So sure, the numbers are low, but in my mind, they could be higher. And so cops need to be more ready to kill people, Adrienne. They sure have seemed hesitant, haven't they?
Yeah, number one, that doesn't seem to be the case. I'd be afraid if they were actually out there hunting us, because that's essentially what this man is encouraging police to do, as opposed to protect and serve, because I thought that that was, you know, hey, their little motto, not to hunt and kill. This guy is dangerous, and this mentality that he is infusing in officers is only gonna hurt us as citizens.
Definitely, definitely. And, you know, I'm not a serious person, so I'm gonna say something that's not particularly serious. So he makes that point there about if you're not for the body armor, the bulletproof vest, we'd be losing way more cops. I'm gonna make a prediction. I don't know Dave Grossman. I really don't. I'm going to guess he's not against restrictions on armor-piercing bullets. I'm just gonna put that out there. I don't know, but he seems really worried about bulletproof vests. We'll see if he's interested in stopping people from getting the technology that would be able to penetrate them. In any event, why is this significant? It's not just significant because he is off giving ballroom speeches that are gonna convince people that they need to do basically become mini Zimmermans. No, it's that he has conducted trainings for every federal law enforcement agency, every branch of the armed forces, and cops in all 50 states, leading seminars and trainings nearly 300 days a year. So admittedly, he rises and grinds, I guess. He does a lot of these trainings, but unfortunately, he's training the sort of people that have the opportunity and seemingly the motivation to use deadly force on a regular basis. And it's not just that the official police training is, you should be terrified, and if you're terrified, pull out your gun and start shooting. It's this guy saying, you've got some sort of natural like hesitation to kill. You need to train that out of you. It's wrong of you to think that killing is a bad thing, Adrienne. And this is just a really, really bad combination here.
Oh, absolutely. You know, it's telling people ignore your instincts and just kill, kill, kill. Like it's problematic to begin with. And I know the Biden administration is supposed to be looking into elements of police reform and things that they can do. And something they might want to look into is having training practices that are uniform and consistent. Because the fact that this guy is getting hired to train law enforcement is very, very scary. And it should not be the case. There's no reason that cops should assume automatically that we're the opposition, that we are in some kind of war. An us them mentality is nothing more than essentially making us target practice.
Yeah, and look, we sort of speculate about what effect this could have. We can't necessarily point directly to causality, but we can look at these sorts of trainings and see who's been involved in them. So for instance, Philando Castile, who was killed during a traffic stop by a cop in 2016, the officer who killed Philando Castile had previously attended a lethal force class called the Bulletproof Warrior. And why are all of these named as if they're just like overly macho, desperate, try-hard YouTubers that are running these things? Because basically that's what they are. They've just aged a bit. So that class was taught by Calibre Press, which claims to train nearly 20,000 officers per year, which should terrify you. Until recently, one of their most prominent speakers was Dave Grossman, as Jamel Hill pointed out. But more training, am I right? Yes, they just need more training. Better question would be which training, and that is a question that they do not want to answer. In any event, we want to give you a bit more of a direct look at what this Grossman guy is all about. So here is what some of what you might have been exposed to had you been one of the people to train in one of these 300 or so classes each year.
Once you've made the decision to take a human life, you're a transformed creature, you're a predator. What does a predator do? They kill. Only a killer can hunt a killer. Are you emotionally, spiritually, psychologically prepared to snuff out a human life in defense of innocent lives? If you can't make that decision, you need to find another job.
Okay, so you saw his face. I'm just gonna put it out there. He looks like every guy in Unsolved Mysteries that they haven't proven did it, but you know he definitely did it. He looked insane. If I was in that crowd, I would have been worried that he might kill me at any moment. And that's the guy that is supposed to train cops to be more ready to deploy lethal force. Not just cops, soldiers, FBI, every law enforcement agency in the country effectively has relied on this guy to help them decide when they need to kill.
The thing that really kind of hit me was saying spiritually aligned to kill. Like, what does this have to do with spiritual? Like, is it like the Holy Spirit needs to be in me and ready so that I can gun down some civilian? Like, whoa, this guy is Captain Extreme.
Yeah, it's the weird combination of not enough people are dying with the weird God stuff. Like, I'm an atheist, I get it. I have no basis for talking about this, but like I feel like sometimes I'm a little bit more familiar with their theology and their Bible than they are. Like Jesus didn't release an album called Locked and Loaded. Like, that's not what he was about. He really seemed to be against some of the killing. Read a Bible, people. But in any event, I wanna jump, heads up to the director, Brandon. I wanna go to the third video, because it gets even weirder, if that's possible.
Cop says, knock down, drag out, fight, cuffed them and stuffed them. Finally get home at the end of the shift, and cop says, gunfight, bad guys down, I'm alive. Finally get home at the end of the incident, and they all say, the best sex I've had in months. Both partners are very invested in some very intense sex. But there's not a whole lot of perks that come with this job. You find one, relax, and enjoy it.
That guy has someone in his basement. I swear to God, someone go and check that guy's basement. Adrienne.
Yeah, I just hope the sex is consensual, because you're right. Like, he is a little bit crazy and a height. Like, that is disgusting. What is he gonna start doing, Viagra ads? Like, come on. The thought of, I just took a life. Yeah, let me go get laid now. That's your selling point? Problems.
That was among the creepiest things that I think I've ever seen. The look on his face at the end. And as we're doing this segment, I'm going to admit, I'm a little bit worried that now that we've done this, that he's going to kill me. I think that there's a chance. So look, if I turn up in weird circumstances, I didn't do it. He definitely did it, everybody. And please check his basement as soon as you can. Anyway, we're like laughing to some extent. It's our defense mechanism. His is spraying with a machine gun. But this is a guy that is influential. This is a guy, all of the people in that room, the mission is, whether he succeeded or not, and maybe he doesn't because he's a terrible speaker, the mission is he wants those guys to leave the room thinking, yeah, I wanna be a bulletproof warrior. I'm gonna kill someone, then I'm gonna go sleep with my wife. That's what we need more of in this country. And hey, what do you know? We live in a country where cops routinely kill people that they didn't have to. It's weird. I don't know what could be leading to that. I just don't understand it.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is, so you don't miss anything.